Hi children, welcome back to your maths class, 8th class. So mathematics, many of us, they really feel that maths is very tough. But in my view, there is no other subject easier than maths. You may wonder, yes, it is a fact, because mathematics is everywhere in our life. In day-to-day moment of our life, the mathematics is there. If you go to market, when you buy anything, you need additions, you need subtractions, you need multiplications, and sometimes you may need even divisions also. That even a lay man can do it, who has not at all seen a school, who has not at all stepped on the step of a school, he can do that things wonderfully. So how it is? Means the only thing what we have to do to be perfect in mathematics is we have to apply what we learn here in day-to-day life. If we apply what we have learned in day-to-day life, then there is no other subject easier than mathematics. No doubt, not only in maths, you take any subject. So many things we see outside, so many things we understand. But when we come theoretically, then we are not able to understand it by our bookish knowledge. But maths makes us difficult by knowing the properties of the numbers, to learn the properties of the numbers, and what is this, and what is the algebra, why these numbers are so, all these things, it makes the mathematics a difficult one. But even now I say that we can apply the same thing in your day-to-day life. You take any aspect of the mathematics, it can be applied in day-to-day life, and we can make it very easy. Okay, so that is about mathematics. Without mathematics, there is no life. What is your age? You say that my age is 15, 16, 17, 42, 48, 50. All these are numbers. These numbers, where from we are getting? We are getting these numbers from mathematics. So, maths is a indivisible part of our life. We cannot expect a life without mathematics. Okay, so that is one. Now, in the initial stages, when suppose let us think that a small kid is there. A small kid of 3 or 4 years is there. Two kids are there, let us take. Some chocolates are given to one kid and some chocolates are given to another kid. So one of them, they got more chocolates than the second one. When one of them got more chocolates than the second one, what happens there? The fellow who got less will quarrel with that fellow. Commonly it happens in each and everyone's case. How they are able to know that this fellow is having more chocolates and this fellow is having less chocolates? It's just by counting. Is it not? Just by counting. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One fellow got 4, another fellow got 6. So now, comparing this, where from the comparison is from? This comparison is from numbers only. So these numbers which we use to count, these are called as, those numbers are called as, you know already, they are called as natural numbers. They are called as natural numbers, which are denoted by letter capital N. So, this is natural numbers of nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, up to countless infinity. So what are the natural numbers? So natural numbers are nothing but the numbers which we used to count. Counting numbers are called as natural numbers. So natural numbers are denoted by capital N, and those numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It continues up to infinity. So this is the natural numbers. Why they are called as natural numbers? Because naturally, when we start counting, we start with 1. Is it not? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, goes on up to infinity. That's why they are called as natural numbers, denoted by letter N. Now, if we add 0 to this list of natural numbers, then they become whole numbers, H-O-L-E, whole numbers. This also we learned in previous classes. It is denoted by capital W, that is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and goes on up to infinity. This goes on up to infinity. So the four whole numbers are the numbers denoted by capital W. Whole numbers are the numbers denoted by capital W. Here, in the set of whole numbers, along with natural numbers, 0 is added. So, natural numbers, they are counting numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 up to infinity. Whereas the whole numbers are the numbers 0 and natural numbers. So, these are called as whole numbers. This also you learned in the previous classes. Then comes integers. What are these integers? Integers. These are denoted by letter capital I. What are these integers? So, why the need of integers raised means? So, you know, in science, you might have drawn graph. If you are moving in one direction, then we take it as positive. Suppose if you are moving in the other direction, what you have to take it as? Suppose if you are moving up, let us say that you have moved up 10 meters and now you want to dig a pit of 5 meters. How can you measure it? We can measure using a tape, that is also 5 meters. But how to represent it? Whether it is above the ground or below the ground? Understood? So here, the need of the integers raised, and that need, it has given the thought of negative numbers. So what are these negative numbers? Means, suppose if you are moving up from the ground, then we say that the building is 10 meters high. If you are going down the ground, we say that the well is 20 meters below the earth, or 20 meters depth. How to represent this height and depth? Can you represent? So to represent this height and depth, the positive and negative is considered. When you move up, it is taken as 10 meters plus 10 meters. The height of the building is 10 plus 10 meters. What is the depth of the well? Depth of the well is minus 20 meters. So means it is moving down to the under the earth. So the integers are the numbers that they start from minus infinity. It goes on and it becomes minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, and it moves on up to infinity. They moves on up to infinity. So, the integers are the numbers which are having both negative numbers, positive numbers, and also zero. So integers are the set of numbers which include negative numbers, positive numbers, and zero. Or otherwise, we can say that integers are the set of numbers of negative numbers and whole numbers, because from zero to this side they are whole numbers now. So here negative numbers and whole numbers, they form the integers. They form the integers. So once again, let me repeat. First set of numbers are natural numbers. So these natural numbers are denoted by capital N, and normal counting numbers which we use to count anything, those are the natural numbers which begin from 1, then followed by 2, 3, 4 up to infinity. Next comes the whole numbers. Whole numbers are denoted by capital W. Whole numbers, they are, 0 is also included. So 0 and the natural numbers, they form the whole numbers. 0 and the natural numbers, they form the whole numbers. Then next comes the integers, denoted by letter capital I. So these integers are the set of the negative numbers, positive numbers, and also zero. Why we represent zero separately here? Because negative numbers means they start from -1, -2, -3 up to minus infinity. Positive numbers means they start from +1, +2, +3 up to infinity. But what about zero? It is neither included in list of negative numbers or in the list of positive numbers. So that's why zero is considered as neither negative nor positive. Neither negative nor positive. So the set of integers, they consist of negative numbers, positive numbers, and zero. So all these things you learned in previous classes. Now, what we are going to learn this year, it is about less. Before going to that, let me introduce you something. Okay, till now we told that so many chocolates are given to you. So we have counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, very good. And you want to measure depth, we took negative, okay, very good. You want to move towards left, we took negative numbers, okay, very good. Suppose if this is the point A, and if you want to move in this direction, then you can see it as 4 meters. And if you move in this direction, you can say it as -3 meters. So integers are used in this way. And if you go down, we'll take it as 10 meters, -10 meters. And if you move up, it is taken as +5 meters in this way. So this is the use of the negative and positive integers. This is okay. Now, you celebrate your birthday or not? Celebrate birthday, no? So on birthday, what will you do? Your lovely parents will buy you a cake so that you can enjoy with your friends. Is it not? Your lovely parents, they buy cake now, and which you can enjoy with your friends. You are enjoying your cake with your friends. Okay, let's think that this is the cake of your birthday cake. One smiley is also there on your cake, which is nicely decorated, is it not? And your name is written here. Happy birthday. This is the cake. Let us think. Now, what will you do? Will you eat entire cake? Or will you give one cake to each guest? No. What we are doing? Here, we are cutting this cake into parts. Is it not? We are cutting this cake into parts. So these parts like this. We'll cut the cake into parts, different parts. When you cut the cake in different parts, what happens? So we are getting, let us take, we have cut that into 10 parts. And you have given one part to each of your friend. Each of your friend. So you have cut this cake into 10 parts and you have given one part each to each of your friend. So how to represent this mathematically? How to represent this mathematically? How much you have given this to with you have to your friend? What part of the cake you have given to your friend? That is to be represented. Understood? So that is to be represented. So how to represent this? Then the thought of rational numbers. Thought of rational numbers is arised. So what is that? Rational numbers. So what are these rational numbers? Before going to the definition of the rational numbers, let us see what you have learned in previous classes. Now how many cakes are there actually? One cake is there. Is it not? And into how many parts it is divided? 10 parts. This cake is divided into 10 parts. One cake is divided into 10 parts. Then what is the value of each part means? We will write in the form of a fraction. So what is this fraction? A fraction consists a divisible line. And below the divisible line, there is denominator. And above the divisible line, it is numerator. So, divisible line, under the divisible line you have denominator and above the divisible line you have numerator. You have divided this cake into 10 parts. Into how many parts you have divided the cake? 10 parts. So, that how many parts are there that you have to write in denominator. Into how many parts you have divided it that you have to make it into denominator. And how many parts you have given to your friend? That you have to write in numerator. Suppose if you have given one part to your friend, then it is 1. You call it as numerator. 1 by 10 or 1 tenth. How to spell it? It is 1 by 10. Or you can call it as 1 tenth. 1 tenth. Okay, understood. So this you learned in lower classes, in third or fourth class itself, you learned how to write the fractions. Suppose one apple is there. You make it into 2 parts. What is the value of each part? Then it is made into 2 parts. Then value of each part is 1. 1 by 2. You call it as half. If you make it into 3 parts, then it is 1 by 3. We call it as 1 third. We call it as 1/3. Did you get the point or not? Okay. So a fraction is written in this form, numerator by denominator. And denominator, how you take? You take the denominator as total number of parts and numerator as how many parts you are getting or you are giving or how many parts it is considered. So this is a fraction. These fractions, in other words, are called as rational numbers. These fractions, in other words, they are called as rational numbers. Okay. So, how these rational numbers, how many are they? Where from it starts? We cannot define where from it starts. Yes. Why this means? When we discuss further, then we can know. We cannot start from here and where we are going to end. What is the next number to rational number? That also we cannot say. You can say, what is the next to plus 1? You can say it as plus 2. What is next to minus 3? You can say it as minus 2. But here, for rational numbers, you cannot say like that. So, a rational number is a number which is having numerator and denominator. So, numerator by denominator gives the rational number. So, numerator and denominator. So, numerator. So, what are the rational numbers? Rational numbers are denoted by or in the form of P by Q. Rational numbers are in the form of P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0. This is general form of rational numbers. This is general form of rational numbers. So what are the rational numbers? Rational numbers are nothing but the fractions. In easy way you can say it. But that is not the correct definition. So rational numbers are the numbers in the form of P by Q, where P and Q, they are whole numbers, but one condition is Q is not equal to 0. So if you take examples, you can take 4 by 3, 1 by 2, minus 6 by 7, 0 by 8, but not 4 by 0. It is not a rational number, because where Q is not equal to 0, that is denominator cannot be 0. In a rational number, numerator can be 0, but denominator cannot be 0. It is not defined. So, rational numbers are the numbers in the form of P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0. Understood? So, these are the examples for rational numbers. 4 by 3, 1 by 2, minus 6 by 7, 0 by 8, 4 by 0 is not a rational number because the denominator is 0. Understood? What is a rational number? A rational number is in the form of P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0. Okay. Now, shall I ask a question? Let us take one digit, one number, let us consider 5. Is it a rational number or not? Is it a rational number or not? No doubt. It is a natural number, it is a whole number, and it is an integer. So if it is an integer, then automatically it is whole number and natural number. Because whole numbers are subsets of integers and natural numbers are subsets of whole numbers. It means that natural numbers are also subset of integers. So not about 5. Is it a rational number or not? If you say no, then it is wrong answer. Why? Because you may say, sir, it should be in the form of P by Q, no? Then only 5 is there, only one number is there. Where is the below number, you may ask? So P by Q is form of P by Q, only 5 is there. So what about that? So if you say, then can you write 5 as 5 by 1? 5 is equal to 5 by 1? Can you write it in this way or not? We can write. So, here 5 is the numerator and 1 is the denominator, which is not equal to 0. Understood? 1 is the, 5 is the numerator and 1 is the denominator, which is not equal to 0. So, all integers are also rational numbers. All integers are also rational numbers. That is, minus 4, you can write minus 4 as minus 4 by 1. 120, you can write 1020 as 1020 by 1. Is it not? All these numbers are rational numbers. So, rational numbers are the numbers in the form of P by Q, where q is not equal to 0, where q is not equal to 0. Okay. So, in other words, you can represent these numbers in this way. If you take this as the natural numbers, and here comes the whole numbers, then comes integers, then comes real numbers which are denoted by capital Q. So this is rational numbers, this is integers, this is whole numbers, and these are natural numbers. Natural numbers. So, rational numbers, integers, whole numbers, and natural numbers. All these are subsets of rational numbers. Understood? So this is the numbers, different numbers, different set of numbers which we discuss in the mathematics. Okay, so different set of numbers. First one is natural numbers, counting numbers, natural numbers plus 0, whole numbers, negative numbers, positive numbers and 0, it is integers, and rational numbers, they are the numbers which are represented in the form of P by Q. And Q is not equal to 0. Okay children, this is enough for today's class. Then just what you are supposed to do is take your mathematics textbook and go through first two or three pages. When I complete the next session, then I will post you some homework, then you can do it. Thank you.